on eBay, you can find these are actually bottle stoppers. They were for they're for wine bottles, and this little version works very good. This one also with the cork for more of a brass car. We got one of our shipments, so let's open it up. And right, there he is. That's what we were looking for. Cleaning out the inner workings of the bottle stopper. So there's a little wire in here. Right now there's a rubber seal in here. It's crusty. Alright. We want to take this out because we're going to plug this. So we're going to use like an AB epoxy here, something like this, a JB Weld, plastic weld would work probably as well, and you can get this at the hardware store. Cut off, you know, you need about the same size, the JB Weld will make that a little easier. So I'm going to take this, we don't want to block these holes here, this hole here, because that's where our water is going to come up through. But we want to have enough in there that we get it to stick good. Alright. Want to make sure that the hole itself is not being plugged. We'll just dig a little bit of that center out there. Kind of came out. We want to put him facing away from the relief hole. Okay, now we get them stuck in there, and then this is where I'm saying we can just get over the lip, and that any pressure, once this stuff hardens, it's pretty good. So it should hold it in place. Before we get it too hard, we're gonna put the glue into the relief hole. Make sure we got that plugged. We're going to leave this harden overnight. We're going to hit that flat spot right there. Now I'm going to hold that down in the center and pack this down in there. Okay, now I'm going to just test to make sure I can see down in the hole that there's no glue in there, but I'm just going to blow strictly from this end. And we are getting a good flow. I've kind of placed our statue upside down so that the weight till this firms up more. Otherwise, it'll tend to take our stem off of center. Alright, now I'm gonna just trim this while it's still soft. Okay, now I'm gonna make sure our stem is pretty straight. Looks pretty good. And we'll let that dry for 24 hours. So at this point, we're going to put a cap on it. It's ready to be assembled. I have various caps that I've gotten over the years. This is a little, I think, herringbone. This is the one we're going to actually use. This might be for a little brass statue. This has already been drilled. Here's one that I did. It's got the little brass, bronze, but on a set of wings. And then this is the traditional. You can get these caps from Lang's or, for example, in brass and in the chrome. So this is probably the traditional cap. It costs about $15-$16. One of the issues, like you'll notice on this one, I have a smaller rod coming out. I've come to the conclusion that the longer rod will allow more of the blow-off water to actually come out. A little unique curvedness in the cap, so I did find this particular washer that has a rubber one side and a steel on the other side, and I'm going to try that in this case. Tighten that all together down there. Okay, now I've turned that pretty good, and basically it's ready to go. We need to make the other part, which is just a little rubber hose. And this needs to go on the bottom of the radiator overflow. I'll try to show this being installed. All this is a little hose with a little screw in there and some tape. So just to attach our little hose down on the overflow. All right, I don't think, know if you can see that, but that is attached on there. Now we fill it up with water. Put on our little statue. And the final step is to start the car up. As the old saying goes, she may be old but still gets hot.